Right. I'm in a no mincing my words situation. So let's have it on here. Let's have a look what's been happening in the world of boxing. Tyson Fury says he'll accept the Dillian White fight on one condition. Well, it's a pay-per-view, isn't it, for starters. Tyson Fury has told the WBC he will take on... Tyson Fury has told the WBC he will take on Dillian White if they agree to make the fight for the diamond belt rather than the interim strap. The WBC had mooted ordering a clash between Fury and White for the mandatory position to Deontay Wilder, but Eddie Hearn insisted the Gypsy King had no interest in taking the fight. But Fury has now performed a U-turn on the idea and said he will accept the fight on one condition. There you go. Well, yeah, but you agree to, okay.
Hi, this is Tyson Fury, aka the Gypsy King. I just want to say a special message to the WBC, who have supported me in my comeback and been very fair with me over the years. Hi, Mauricio. I recently saw your quote about fighting for the interim title against Dillian White, and I'm very thankful for the opportunity. But what I suggest is, because I beat Deontay Wilder, and we all know what happened, I didn't get the decision, but I still won, and the world knows. I propose that we make me and Dillian White for the WBC diamond belt, and not the interim belt. And I'll take care of Dillian White, and I'll knock him out in 6 rounds. I accept the challenge. Thank you very much. I fight Dillian White every day of the week and twice on a Sunday, WBC. Make it for the diamond belt, not the interim version, and you got a deal. Let's get it on!
Because we don't get along. Now, whatever Tyson Fury says, I take as a pinch of salt, because, you know, he says things off for effect, doesn't he, but never really backs them up. We've gone into this in past, haven't we? You know, he gave money to charity and stuff like that, and he said he's retiring, and he hadn't, and one thing or another, he says things for effect. But he's got a big heart, Tyson, he's not all bad. But, as far as I'm concerned, Dillian White, he needs to get a move on with his career, doesn't he? Because he's not fought for a European title yet, or a world title. Now, he's good enough to win a world title, but he needs to get a move on. If he fights Tyson and loses, he's still in that mix. He's putting his cent in that big four. Because at the moment, all it is really, is just a big two, innit? Plus Joshua. It's Tyson and Wilder, and Joshua three, maybe. White's knocking on the door for that fourth position. He needs to get his cent in the mix. But he's fighting Oscar Rivers, and it's not a bad fight. It's better than old Tyson and... who is it fighting though, isn't it? Wilder, but... But anyway, which brings me to Tyson Fury. Which brings me to the Steffi Bull show. We'll get this in before we go through other stuff. Yeah, Steffi show. Which brings me to Steffi Bull show at the Donny Dome. Where Steffi Bull, real name Andrew Bullcroft, let's not forget that. That's his real name. We don't want imposters on the show, do we? My real name's Russell Hartley. Google me. I'm on Google. His real name's Andrew Bullcroft, or Little Andy Pandy as he's known as in Denneby. Now, Little Andy has got an exclusive deal with Donny Dome. Now, he's just gone 9-9 at the Donny Dome. So, 9 home fighters won at the weekend. It weren't on TV because there's no TV deal. But he could have had it on Free Sports, but he didn't want to get his fighters out there, so... So I couldn't really get a bet on for the show. But it's nice to know my old mucker, Andy Pandy, keeping his average up with 9 out of 9. 9 out of 9 wins. He's there again, rain or shine. It's Andy B, innit? On home turf at the Fortress, Donny Dome. Six of them had losing records out of the nine, though. But, to be fair, Anthony Tomlinson, he won his fight against this guy, and the guy he beat were undefeated now. Anthony Tomlinson, he's 10-0, five knockouts. And he's now beat two undefeated guys, Anthony Tomlinson. So, Dempsey Whale, he won as well, so that's good, isn't it? I wasn't really interested in any rest of them on that show. But I'll put it up just to show that I'm not going to miss anybody out who fought on the show. Anthony Tomlinson, Boxrec. He's a dedicated kid, Anthony. Eats all right food, trains hard. So all you can do is try, can't you? Ooh. Hang on a minute. Frank Sinatra. Here we go. Here we go. Right, let me get this up now. I spend all my life trying to get onto Boxrec. Be like Eddie Aime with that Dennis Lewandowski. He got in for Fabio Wardley and he turned up nearly 26 stone in ring. Oh, that's what you get from matching off Boxrec. Right, Steffi Bull's show at the weekend. You click on Anthony Tomlinson, you clicked it right, where it says Kyle Fox. Click on event. Dom Hunt, 2-0, he beat a guy 6-93. So Steffi's opening fight, he's got a guy with 93 losses against Dom Hunt. Dom Hunt's 2-0, and he's giving, and he's £2 heavier than the other kid. Dempsey Whale, he's giving away £6 on his debut against Qasim Hussain, 4-84-2. Dempsey won 4 rounds, over 4 rounds he won on points. Won comfortably, so well done Dempsey Whale, he's one for the future. James Flint, 5-0, beat Carl Tunney on points, who's 0-3-0. Jack Roberts, on his debut, beat a guy with 160 losses, Ibra Rayaz. Connor Coghill, 4-0 against Jack Pollard, 0-5 points. Jamie Hughes, 6-0 against Kent Kupinen with 13 losses, 3-13. Then you've got Levi Kinsiona, 4-0 against Jordan Ellison, 11-21 in a draw, right. The first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the first 7 fights all went to points. All of them went to point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the first 7 fighters are all undefeated. The 8th fight on the night, he were undefeated, Anthony Tomlinson. So Steffi's showing that all his kids are undefeated, that's good. Anthony Tomlinson fought Kyle Fox, who's 6-0. So that's a good fight, isn't it? 9-0 against a 6-0 fight. And Anthony Tomlinson won by knockout, the only knockout on the night. So that's good. And then you've got Jason Cunningham, old warhorse, 24-6, fighting Josh Kennedy, 11-1. That's actually a good fight, that. Jason won over 10 rounds. So, all in all, not a bad show, but not a TV show, but it's not a bad show, that. It'd be interesting to see where he goes with Levi Kinsiona and Anthony Tomlinson next. Of course, Anthony Tomlinson said on social media he's game to fight Frankie Gavin. Now, well, we're going to see, aren't we? Whether that'll be at 147 or what, I don't know. Frankie would take that fight, but it'd probably be £150. If Anthony Tomlinson's interested in fighting Frankie Gavin at £150, maybe they should get in touch. Maybe his manager should get in touch with other people's managers and make that fight. And I'm not just saying get in touch with Dennis, because I don't know what Frankie's position is on that fight now, but Frankie Gavin would fight Anthony Tomlinson all day at 150. That could even be built up into an headline fight, that, at 147. I don't know if Frankie can do weight now. I don't know, but Anthony Tomlinson says all right things, does all right things, 10-0, 5 knockouts, coming up to 28-year-old, needs to get a move on now. Welterweight, eats right, trains hard, he's punching hard now, but it looks like he's done well to stop Kyle Fox, who's never been stopped. He's never even been in trouble, to be honest, Kyle. So that is a good win. And so who was this off? I'm just filming, pal. I'll give you a ring when I finish. But yeah, that's a good win for Anthony Tomlinson, because I were hearing that Kyle Fox would be too big for him from Kyle's team, but that's a good win for him against Kyle Fox. I bet he didn't go down very well in Doncaster as well, because he's got a bit of a following, hasn't he, Kyle? Jason Cunningham, I like Jason Cunningham. I think he's a good fighter. But he's had 6 losses, Jason, now, hasn't he? But he's just got distance with Conlon, so. And he's only been stopped once, Jason, and that was against Reese Bellotti. So I think there's still many miles left for Jason there. But Jason's fighting a super bantam. That'd be an interesting fight, wouldn't it? Jason Cunningham against Josh Whale. That'd be a very interesting fight. One I'd want to see. Ross Birkinshaw beat Jason. Jason must have been having a bad night to lose against Ross the Boss. That's Ross's best win, that. But it looks like it's been an half decent show there for Steffi. I heard they want money there, but. You know, credit's where credit's due. He's put a lot of undefeated kids on. They're all undefeated by the looks, isn't it? Except all on fighters undefeated except the last fight. So that's good. That he's got a good little stable going there. But are any of them going to go all the way? I don't know. Tomlinson maybe wins in English. Maybe wins in English. He might be 2 years off a British title win yet. He'd have to be matched correctly to win that, but maybe. Conor Benn against Anthony Tomlinson, that's a good fight. Josh Kelly. See, all these are good fights. There's fights for all them out there. Levi Kinsayona. Let's have a look. Levi Kinsayona, light welterweight or super lightweight. Glenn Foote, that's a good fight for him. Glenn Foote, I'd like to see him. He's just got beat against Robbie Davis Jr. Why don't Steffi take a chance and throw him in with him? Porky, what do you know about boxing? What do you know about boxing? Well, I know that you can't keep treading water at Doncaster Dome, putting guys on against guys for and knowing they're just going to win. Every now and then you've got to roll the dice. You can't keep waiting for Eddie Hearn to call you, so you throw your kids under a bus. You've got to go out and you've got to grab the bull by the horns. Glenn Foote hasn't fought for 7 months, he's got no fight lined up, and he's coming off a loss. But he's a good kid, and he's got a good reputation, 23-4, and you'd see where Levi is in that fight, wouldn't you? Or if Glenn Foote, who maybe might be stepping up to welterweight, that'd be a good fight for Anthony Tomlinson. You know, he could do a fight in something like that. Somebody coming off a loss at light welter who's looking at moving up. That's a good fight, I think. You know, you've got to mix it up a bit and roll the dice and see how you're going. I mean, who am I to tell Steffi Bullard to do his job anyway? But Anthony Tomlinson's probably a TV fighter. He's stopping people. You know, he's got a good look about him. He's got a bit of a good story. Why not? Who's to say he might not sign for Dennis anyway next 9 months? We never know, do we? You never know what's around the corner in boxing, do you? You never know what's around the corner, but Levi's just fought a guy ranked 454. Now, maybe it's time for him to step up now. He's coming to that halfway of half. 10 fights on board is great. Well, his next fight's going to be his fifth, so that's that first learning curve out of the way. He's been a professional now a year, so maybe it might be time to roll the dice. Maybe about October, Christmas time for Levi. You never know, dear, but time to roll the dice. Maybe Levi might want to step up. Who knows, but he's only 23. He's got plenty of time on his hands, but remains to be seen, but 5-0 already. He's just had his fifth fight. He's finding his legs, isn't he, though? 11 months as a pro. He's maybe a year off a fight with Glenn Foote. But Anthony Tomlinson's already looking for his 11th fight. He's got a title. He's a man in a rush. So, but they're two for the future then. I want to see that Conor Benn. I want to see somebody knock Conor Benn out. I want to see somebody ice Conor Benn from round here. That's what I want to see. I want to see a big puncher. We want to see punches. We want to see people getting iced. You know, Glenn Foote against Lee. Glenn Foote against Anthony Tomlinson at 140. What about that for a fight? Now, Anthony Tomlinson's weighed 141. He's weighed 136 against Simas Voloshinas. 136. He's weighed 151.5 against Kevin McCauley. So there's a 15.5-pound swing there. So Anthony Tomlinson can do 135. He's done 136. He can do 135 up to 154 because he's done 151.5. So Anthony Tomlinson, he could fight Frankie Gavin at 154, couldn't he? He could fight Frankie Gavin at 154. Steffi, Anthony Tomlinson against Frankie Gavin at £154. What do you reckon? I think that's a good fight, that, me. All them people out there who work for Steffi will all be on phone now telling board I'm talking to fighters. Watch this. Because I like to know who's telling tales. Watch this. I don't hold a license with board. Watch this. Let's have a bit of fun. Hey, Frankie, I've just been thinking. I'll tell you what's a good fight. Because I know he's struggling at 147. You against Anthony Tomlinson at 154. Or a catch weight between 147 against... Between 147 and 152. Because Anthony Tomlinson on here's weighed in at 151. At 151.5 pounds. Against Kevin McCauley in Liverpool. 151.5 he weighed. McCauley weighed 154. And Anthony wasn't bothered, he beat him up on points. What do you reckon? Let me know what you think. It's just an idea, mate. Just trying to help you out, Frankie. Hope you're alright, mate. You take care. Give me a ring. Cheers, mate. What do you think to that? Hey? I think that'd be a good fight, that. A good fight in Sheffield, that, on Free Sports TV, Anthony Tomlinson headlining on TV in Sheffield against Frankie Gavin coming up with a busload of fans. Good fight, that. Former British champion, Olympian, world amateur gold. I think that's a great fight. Could fight on Free Sports telly, that. Could do it in Barnsley on somebody's undercard. I think it's a good fight, that. But I think that's about it, really. That's about it with me trying to play Mr. Matchmaker. I just like to see good fights, and I like to see kids do well. Like I said, Jason Cunningham won, Jamie Hughes won, Conor Coghill won, Jack Roberts, James Flynn, Dempsey Wale, they all won on points. And who's to say that, because Anthony Tomlinson can go from lightweight all the way up to light middle, he's just shown there. That's a 19 pound swing. So he's available at lightweight, light welter, welter, light middle. He can fight in four divisions, Anthony Tomlinson. He could fight Dempsey Wayle in another 2 years. Dempsey Wayle against Anthony Tomlinson at 140. That's a good fight as well, isn't it? I think so. Local derby. Eh? That'll be nice and spicy in 2 years, that. That'll be spicy in a couple of years, that. Dempsey Wayle against Anthony Tomlinson. But it is what it is, isn't it? But I heard the highlight of the night was Dave Allen eating 3 Lion bars ringside. So Dave wouldn't have been bothered about eating Lion bars though ringside, would he? Because TV cameras weren't there, would they? Normally, at a normal show, he has to go in the toilet to eat a Lion bar. Or is it chomps, Dave? What is it, Dave? Chomps or Lion bars? But anyway, in other news, boom, water is wet.